Elders, brothers, sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. The night has indeed naturally come to a peak, a momentum that, as I said at the start, is a gift, it is a grant, it is a mercy upon all of us here this evening. The latest is going to finish with the sehri upstairs. The salat al tasbih will be, inshallah, offered straight after my speech. So inshallah, those of you who are keen to offer that worship, I hope that that's satisfied you in particular. Our young Sayyid Badshah has spoken very eloquently about a topic which I think what I want to focus on as well, and it's exceptionally important. I've been thinking long and hard about this evening's speech. And my students who come here regularly, I discuss with them as well on Friday. I know for a fact that there are some people sat in this audience here today listening to this speech who perhaps were not here on at Maghrib time, they perhaps weren't here at Asr time, they perhaps may not have been here at Dhuhr, perhaps not even at Fajr. Maybe they weren't blessed enough to come to visit the masjid this last Friday for Salatul Jumu'ah. Some of us, and this is why I started this evening by saying Mubarak, congratulations to you all, because Allah has chosen you. Allah has granted you His permission to come into His home, His house, and allowed you to be part of this special night of worship. I know for a fact, I've been part of the masjid system for many, many years, ever since, well, from the beginning, if you like. And it's a great time of happiness, a great time of joy when we see people in the masjid like we have here tonight, full to the max, if you like. People who we perhaps haven't seen actually for many, many days, many months, even many weeks, many years perhaps. And this is my first time here in this grand masjid of Central Victoria Park Masjid here in Manchester. I haven't been here for Shura Barat before, but I'm talking to you about my own masjid over in Rochdale. Every year I get exceptionally emotional, I get exceptionally upset. But why is it that I'm only seeing my brothers on an annual basis? Why is it that I'm seeing these faces for the first time in over a year? And they say to me, well, you are the one who tells us. You are the one who repeats these ahadith from our noble Habib alayhi salatu wasalam, that Ya Allah, this is an opportunity to seek His forgiveness and His mercy. You're the one who tells us to come. And then you are sad that you see us on this annual basis. The sadness, brothers and sisters, is that we only see some of you on this occasion annually. And it is a message to some of you, and I'm very, very, very conscious of that. But the Lama Sahib spoke before me and he said, you know what? This is a night for those part-time Muslims who come to receive forgiveness because they have sinned. They know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy descends upon them this evening. They know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is there to be received. But ya akhi, my dear, dear brother, and my dear sister listening upstairs, Allah definitely tells us in the Holy Quran that His mercy is never to be despaired. His mercy is always there. You should never despair. You should never lose hope from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But my dear, dear brother, my worry is this. My worry is this. Is that you today have been granted permission to receive his mercy, You today have entered His mercy and His domain by coming to the masjid. But tomorrow will you be here? The day after will you be here? Many people have inquired and said, Imam Sahib Mawlana Sahib, when is it the time for Salat al-Tasbih? And I had to look up the maqam in fiqh in terms of Salat al-Tasbih, and you know what? It's a nafil ibadah. And there are what? How many other levels of ibadah above it that are perhaps even more important? There is sunnah, of course, mu'akkada and ghayr mu'akkada. Three there. Then there is wajib, four. And then there is, of course, fard, the fifth. So there are 4 degrees less to when you get to this nafil salah of Salat al-Tasbih, and there are 4 levels above which you should be doing anyway. And again, I know that there are people listening to my speech, and you might find this uncomfortable, who perhaps even struggled during the Salat al-Isha there to say, you know what? It's been a long time since I've been in this masjid. It's been a long time when I've had the opportunity to even pray those qunuts. And perhaps some of us were even worried about what those words actually said. But I don't want to give you that. I don't want to leave you with that despair. What I want you to do this evening is that you have to realize that you have been chosen. You have to realize that it is through God's mercy and His blessings that you are here this evening. But you must never, ever reject that mercy. And what do I mean by reject that mercy? The rejection of that mercy, my dear brothers, and please take these words and take them however you like, but really focus on them. The rejection of Allah's mercy tonight will be the test for that will be whether or not you offer your fard salah tomorrow. Whether or not you wake up for your fajr salah tomorrow. Whether or not you are actually obedient to your Lord in every single aspect tomorrow, not just tonight. This is a night of mercy. There's no doubt about it. This is a night of karam. No doubt about it. This is a night of repentance, no doubt about it. But all of that will be absolutely wasted. All of that will be absolutely false if tomorrow, 24 hours later from today, you have not changed your ways. That, my dear brothers and sisters, is your test and my test. And this is not me being angry. This is not me being emotional. I just said to him, Shasab, forgive me if I get emotional. And this is not, it really isn't. What this is about is one brother to another brother. This is a reminder to you all. Today, these hands we're in control of. These mouths we're in control of. These feet we're in control of. But Surah Yasin, we read it whenever we get an opportunity. Focus on the last few verses of Surah Yasin. Al-Yawm.
Nakhtim.
Al-Yawm. Nakhtimu ala afwahihim. Wa tukallimuna aydihim. Wa tashhad arjulahum bima kanu yaksibun. We are very proud of these hands today. I can pull out my phone, I can drive my car, I can tap on a computer, I can do whatever I want with these hands. I can earn my halal earning. I can go to my factory, my shop, my takeaway, my restaurant, my taxi, my office, my whatever. I can do whatever I want with these hands. I am in control of these hands today. But Allah tells us that on that day, these hands will not be in your control. These mouths that speak and shout so emotionally, like I am doing right now. And may Allah have mercy upon me first and foremost before any one of you. This tongue that I am using to speak to you today, Who knows how many promises I broke? Who knows how many lies I committed? Who knows how many falsehoods I made mistakenly, deliberately, not knowing who, but by the fareb of shaitan? Who knows? I am in control of my tongue today, but tomorrow on that final day of judgment, nakhtim ala afwajihim. Nakhtim ala afwajihim. These mouths of ours will be sealed. There will be no conversation. There will be no talking. There will be no giving your innocence. No, nothing. The hands will do the talking. The hands will do the talking. When you kallimuna aydihim, look at the verse of Surah Yasin. This hand that you today control. And you know, I often say this, the biggest fitna that is cursing our ummah and has corrupted our youth is the fitna of the phone. We have umpteen messages, umpteen Facebook accounts, WhatsApps, and all sorts of stuff. Yes, we use it for our benefit. But at the same time, put yourself on the test, my dear brother. If you were absolutely true to yourself, give this phone to the brother next to you and say, go through my history. Go through my internet browser history. Check it out. Are you all going to be 100% committed? Are you all going to be 100% honest enough to be able to show me? And I, who am I? Who am I? And we think we can do this sin and hide from Him, Allah. And yet you're not willing to share with me your internet browsing history right now, right here, or is anyone able to do that? The fitna of the phone, my dear brothers and sisters, is perhaps the biggest fitna that we face in this society. How many marriages I know that have broken because of the fitna of this phone? How many young people whose innocence has been totally looted from them because of the fitna of the phone? And I say to this, my message to my brothers, my elders, mere baladain, mere buzurgon, mere bhaiyon, mere maa behne jo sun rahi hain, ye phone ka jo fitna hai, tum leke de diya hai tumne apne bachchon ko, apne bachiyon ko. Meri apni bachi 10 saal ki badi bachi, alhamdulillah, Allah taala usko salamat rakhe, sehat de. Aksar aap se uski liye dua ki guzarish karta hoon. Meri apni behti ki main misal deta hoon, I'm not going to speak about anybody else. She said to me for the last six months, you've been saying, Daddy, everybody in my class has got an iPhone 5 and I haven't. Everybody in my class. And she's in year 5. The fitna of the phone starts as early as that. And I said to her, I was shocked with myself. I sent her a long message on the same medium that I'm just talking about. Through the message, I said to her, Faiza, I'm never ever going to send this message to you again. But all I'm going to say to you is that I want never to be able to, for you to seek my permission for what you are going to download on this and what you are going to use on this. You are an intelligent young lady and you know the difference between what is right and what is wrong. I want to be able to trust you. How many of us can say that about our own daughters and our own sons? How many fathers sat here right now are perishan, are worried, and are stressed because their daughters can't get married, because their sons are not getting married? How many of you are there here right now who are worried about that? I would say the majority. And it's all down to the fitna of the phone. I'm not saying get rid of it. I'm not saying don't use it. You see me on this 24/7. What I am saying to you is be responsible. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His awareness, His knowledge of what we do, yukhfi ma fi sudur, there is nothing that can be hidden within our hearts. Allah is the knower of all of that. And that is what we need to focus on. That is what we need to be crystal clear about. That we hide ourselves in these little screens, but Allah is always there watching us. How can we possibly possibly think that we can get away with all of the evil and all of the wrong that we do on these, not just on this medium, but on other mediums like that. My dear brothers, my message to you this evening is come. Come into the presence of Allah. Come, repent to Allah and allow Him to transform your hearts. Allow Him to change your lives. We want this evening here tonight to be a real opportunity for you to change. We're going to break shortly into Salat al-Tasbih. And let me say a few words on that before we do that. In Salat al-Tasbih, why is it called Salat al-Tasbih? The prayer of the praise. And those of you who've never offered this prayer, for you, it might be a little bit different, it might be a little bit confusing. But those of you who have will remember that in Salat al-Tasbih you read these words, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah wa alhamdulillahi wa la ilaha illallah wa Allahu Akbar. These three phrases. And we repeat them initially 15 times and then 10 times every time we make a movement in our salah. And what I want you to think about, this, remember I said to you about these hands, they will do the talking. These limbs, every single body, every single muscle in your body will feel the pain this evening with that prayer. It will feel it. But when you feel that pain, the praise that you are doing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glory be to my Lord, Subhanallahi walhamdulillahi wa la ilaha illallah wa Allahu Akbar. Glory and praise and thanks and takbir. Every single time you make a movement, you will feel that different parts of your body will feel the pain. And what I want you to think about at that moment in time is the sins that that part of your body has committed. I want you to think about those sins that you made that body commit. وَعَلَى جَسَدِكَ حَقٌ. Your body, every single aspect of your body has a right over you. And every single aspect of your body will be answerable. You will be answerable to it on the final day of judgment. So when we're reading the Salat al-Tasbih, don't let it just be a ritual thing. Don't let it just be, oh, I'm doing this because I've been told to do it. I'm here because it's a special night. No. Make it into a practical exercise of your spiritual betterment. Make it an opportunity where you are reflecting upon yourself. You just heard Sajjana Sahib speak about Allah's Habib making istighfar. Why did he need to seek forgiveness? Absolutely ma'soom and from all types of sin and yet still making istighfar. That is him teaching us how we need to be going towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That isn't him seeking his own forgiveness because he had no sins to forgive for. That is him essentially asking for forgiveness on our part, teaching us how to receive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. My dear brothers and sisters, I said to you I was only going to speak for 12 minutes. I've gone over my limit. I want to make one final announcement before we do the instructions for Salat al-Tasbih. This masjid, alhamdulillah, I've been here for a good few months now, and I'm very, very grateful to the organizing management committee, and in particular to some of our young brothers, students who have come regularly. We've decided that this class that we have, we run a weekly class, and I bet you there are many, many, I'm not a betting man, I shouldn't set that phrase, but I'm sure there are many people here who perhaps don't even know that we have classes here on a Friday evening. But what we've decided to do is we've decided to make some intensive short courses. Because there are lots of people out there in our communities, and many of you will be perhaps here yourselves, who haven't had the opportunity to receive the basics of the deen. So some of the core, basic, essential things about the deen we did an examination for the young students just on Friday. And some of the questions in there, I thought to myself, you know what? If I was to distribute that questionnaire, that question paper, to all of you here tonight, I'm pretty sure that many of you will unfortunately fail those basic questions. And that's no fault of your own. That's just about opportunity. That's just about, you know, experiences. So what I'm, inshallah, proposing to do, and we've already started the first session, various different short courses, about 10 or 12 weeks in a slot, for 1 hour each Friday evening. 1 hour each Friday evening. Now you've come to this masjid, and you've spent this evening, mashallah, many of you came here at Salatul Maghrib around just after 9:15, and now it's 12:15. That's 3 hours you've spared. What I'm asking from you is that you spare 1 hour per week. And I'm not going to ask you to raise your hands because you're raising your hands in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I said to you before, one of the reasons, one of the ways that you will be showing, if you like, discredit, or you will be showing almost an insult to the mercy that you're receiving from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the test for you is how you behave tomorrow. Not how you behave today. It's going to be about how you behave tomorrow. So this is an open invitation to all of you, brothers and my dear sisters. We create good mothers, we create good nations. And that's why it's really important that we have our sisters also come to these classes. We're going to do various different short courses, our belief, our aqidah, the core of what we believe. Fiqh, how we should actually be praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we should be worshipping Him. How many of you here who are married don't answer this question. How many of you here who are married don't actually know how to do a proper ghusl, as our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us? I don't want you to answer that question right now, but think about it. Many, many divorce cases come to me every single week, and I'm very, very saddened. And I wish, and I often say this, I wish those same couples who come to me for divorce advice, I wish they did the fiqh of marriage beforehand. I wish they did the laws of regulations of knowing what it means to be a husband, what it means to be a wife. We don't do these teachings, but inshallah we will be doing here. And then of course the noble seerah of our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we want to know how to live our lives, we live in accordance to the life of the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then also a big thing, lots of questions already coming in about this. Ramadan time is coming close, Allah Ta'ala bless us all with that, witnessing that blessed month. Often we will be giving our financial worship, we will be giving zakat in this time. How do we actually calculate our zakat? Many of you here, I know, alhamdulillah, are from the business community. How do we ensure that all of our bonds, our various investments, all of these different types of financial investments that you have today, how do we ensure that all of that is properly accountable for? And other things, inshallah, similar other things like that. There is a leaflet that we prepared about this course. We will be asking you to register. There is absolutely no cost for this course whatsoever. But we are saying to you, please register your interest either through the website or through our new Facebook page, which is Manchester Central Mosque, should I say. Please do log on to that and register your interest, inshallah. That will be, again, if you like, your test of receiving Allah Ta'ala's rahmah and grace from this evening. And inshallah, Aziz, we're teaching lots and lots of you like we are here this evening. I hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts what we have said here this evening. And I hope and pray that none of you are offended personally by what I have said this evening. If you have been offended, then all I will ask you to do is check your hearts. Ask yourself, why is it that you've been offended by what I've said? And if at all, in any way, shape or form, that has still remained, then I will ask you once again publicly to forgive me for any words that I have said.
What time is the class?
The class, inshallah, is 7 o'clock, Salat al-Asr, is 7 o'clock, straight after Asr Salah, till, inshallah, about an hour or so. We try to keep it brief, not too much, so it's not too laborious for people. But thank you very much for questioning that. That is also Friday evenings. I've been saying to the lads here, you know, Friday night out at the VP Masjid. Let's call it something like that. Let's make it a little bit fun. Those of you who've been to the class, I'm very grateful to all of you. They will tell you how entertaining that class can be. that will tell you how serious it can be, and they will tell you how emotional and spiritual it can be. So we like to try and do a little bit of all of that for you, inshallah, Aziz. Please do, as I say, register your interest, and inshallah, we will make that a very, very successful class. Jazakumullah khair for listening. We're now going to break for Salat al-Tasbih. Those of you who have not prayed it, it is intended, I'm looking at my watch here, the way that we offer it is either you can do it in four rak'ats or you can do it in two sets of two. And I think the state that we're all in here, the air conditioning seems to be working now, but we'll do it in two sets of two. And it's very, very simple. It's more difficult for me to keep on track as the Imam leading, but for yourselves, I will, at the juncture of every start of every movement, we will make that tasbih. Okay? Subhanallah, walhamdulillahi, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. That tasbih, that's why it's called Salat al-Tasbih, we will make that tasbih initially 15 times, and then every movement that we do next after that, we will make it 10 times. That will give us a total 300 if my maths is not incorrect. So that is the way we do it. All you need to do is make your niyyah, but I would say for those brothers and sisters, and this is me included, please don't ever think that because I'm your imam here, I must be some supernatural angelic being. No. Kullu ibn Adam khatta'un. Kullu ibn Adam khatta'un. Every single child of Adam is a sinner. وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّاعِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. But the best of those sinners are those who come and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance. That's what I'm going to be doing here this evening, and that is what you're going to be doing, inshallah, with me. Please, stand up, and inshallah, I'll be able to proceed with that, inshallah, and so that you can speak.